Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Tom J. McCoy and I'm a director from Arizona. Today I'm doing a really fast tutorial on editing high frame rate footage and how to convert it to a 24 FPS timeline. So I have a 60 FPS clip right here that I shot on my Canon 80D. So if I play this footage back, it's just gonna play at normal speed. So if I wanna convert that to the exact 24 to 60, speed ratio, I'll just right click the clip and go to modify and interpret footage. And you get this whole menu that pops up, but we're only concerned with this area right here, frame rate. So you can see it's 59.94, but we're just gonna click on assume this frame rate and type in 23.98. And you can do 24 FPS, you can do 23.976, it doesn't matter. My camera just shoots in 23.98, so that's what I'm gonna type in right there. So just press okay. And now if I go back to this footage, you can see that Premiere now recognizes it as 23.98 and has slowed the footage down to compensate and match that. So it's really fast, it's really easy to do, and there's a lot of advantages of doing it this way. So if I took this clip, actually I'm gonna duplicate this right now. Right now I'm just gonna talk about the advantages of doing it that way. If that's all you needed, awesome, tutorial's over. But let me just talk real quick about why this is important. So if I took this clip and I've made, hopefully Premiere doesn't crash when I do this, because sometimes it does, and I put it back to 60. Now I have this one, 23.98, and I'll create a comp out of that, and I'll take this 61 and create a new comp out of that one. So this is our 60 playing back at normal speed, and this is our 24 playing back in slow motion. So what most people will do, this is the 61 if you didn't see me click, they'll plug it into their timeline just like this, and they'll say, okay, now I just need to slow it down, and they'll go to speed and duration and slow it down. The problem with that is that Premiere sees it as slowed down footage now. It doesn't recognize it as what the rest of your timeline is. So if I wanted to add like a warp stabilizer to this, Premiere wouldn't let me do it because you can't time remap and motion track and all that stuff at the same time. So doing it this way isn't the right way to do it. And you're also not getting the exact frame rate. But with the 24 FPS conversion, I can still stabilize my footage, motion track, you know, do visual effects, all that kind of stuff that I need to do. So it's a lot easier to do. And most people actually do it the wrong way, and that's why I'm making this tutorial, because I've seen a lot of people do it that way. So this is gonna save you a lot of time and energy. But that's really the whole tutorial I wanted to do. Real quick, I just wanna talk about some tips on shooting slow motion, because I get asked that a lot. So the biggest tip that I have is making sure you have the correct shutter angle or shutter speed. So this was shot at 60 FPS. So my shutter speed, you want to have 180 degree ratio. So some cameras, like cinema cameras, will let you do shutter angle, which should be at 180 degrees. But DSLRs and some cinema cameras, like the Canon ones, have the option to do shutter speed. So you want it to be basically double your frame rate. So this was 60, so my shutter speed should be 120, but DSLRs don't let you do it. But so mine was at 125. And if you're shooting at 120 frames per second, then it should be at 240 and so on. 240 frames per second should be at 480, all that kind of stuff. So that's the biggest tip that I have, is to just make sure you have the right shutter angle, shutter speed. The second one, and this kind of goes without saying, but the faster your shutter speed is, the more light you're gonna have to compensate with. So be prepared to open up by a stop of light every time you go to high frame rate footage. So 24 to 60 would be one stop of light. 60 to 120 is another stop of light. So just be prepared to do all that, because you want to keep that in camera as much as you can, so you're not pushing the limits of what your footage is capable of, you know, the color space. So those are the two biggest tips that I have. But I mean, that's the whole tutorial. It's really fast. So be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And thank you guys very much for watching. Bye.